والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. أما بعد, we praise Allah تبارك وتعالى and we seek Allah's guidance and forgiveness, and I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah تبارك وتعالى, and I bear witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of the prophets. May peace and blessing be upon him and his companion and those who follow his sunnah until the day of judgment. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, what are the names and the attributes of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? Is Ar-Rahman. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman means the Lord that provides mercy to the mankind. Not only to the mankind, but for all of his creations. Be it the mankind or other types of creations, Allah is the one that provides the rahmah, mercy and kindness. In this dunya, Ar-Rahim specifically means the one that provides mercy and rahmah to the believers. So today, inshallah ta'ala, our khutbah will be the reasons that can make us receive and obtain the mercy of Allah ta'ala, Ar-Rahmah. Without the rahmah, we will not be here. Without the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, we will not be here. Islam is the religion of Ar-Rahmah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, when he was describing the message that was sent with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have not sent you nothing but to be rahmah, to be mercy to the mankind. So Islam being religion of rahmah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. That my rahmah, my mercy, my kindness exceeds everything. Everything. Every creation that you see lives under the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Every creation, every human being, Muslim or non-Muslim, every other creature is under the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and without the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, none could have existed. So today, our khutbah will be about how can we gain the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, every time that you ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, you supplicate to give you his rahmah, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will give you and will relieve you with any kind of pain and suffering that you may endure. So it's always important that we remember that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is the only one that can provide rahmah and relief from all the suffering and anguish that every one of us suffers. If you remember, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala bi rahmatihi, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala bi rahmatihi saved Ibrahim alayhi salam from the fire when the kuffar thrown him on the fire. With the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah saved him. Allah is the one that saved Yusuf alayhi salam many occasions, specifically when he was thrown in the well and also when he was put in the jail. With the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he survived. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala also is the Lord that saved Yunus in the stomach and the darkness of the fish that has swallowed. With the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah saved and survived. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is the one that saved with his rahmah Nabiullah Musa alayhi salam, when Fir'aun and his soldiers were chasing them in the midst of the ocean. With the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah is the one that has saved. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that saved our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was in the ditch with his friend Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. With the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah saved him from the tyranny of the Kuffar. So when the situation seems to be very tense, you need to remember Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You need to ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to give you rahmah. So some of the things that we need to remember in order to get the blessing of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, in order to gain the rahmah. Once you get the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, what else you will ask? Some of the things to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is al-iman billah, to believe in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, the iman. You know, no matter how much wealth you have, no matter how much your life is prestige, no matter how much of a position of authority that you occupy, this will not bring any rahmah. Well, one of us. That's why you see people who commit most of the suicides are people with wealth, people with names, people with prestige. Okay, celebrities are the ones that kill themselves because they don't have that rahmah of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So, in order to enjoy the rahmah of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, you should be a true believer of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Look at Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has said, فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فَيُدْخِلُهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ فِي رَحْمَتِهِ. Those who believe in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and do righteous deeds, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will put them into His rahmah. ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْفُوزُ الْمُبِينُ. Secondly, another way to gain the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is to obey the commands of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and the commands of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, أَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Obey Allah and obey His Messenger, and in return Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will have mercy on you. So obeying Allah and His Messenger is a reason for us to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. In another ayah. Another reason to gain the rahmah and the kindness and the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is to follow the book of Allah and His sunnah, as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My rahmah exceeded and reached everywhere without any limitation. فَسَأَكْتُبُهَا عَلَيْهِ. We give that rahmah لِلَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ, those who have taqwa. وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ, those who give the zakat. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ بِآيَاتِنَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, and those who believe in the verses of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيِّ الْأُمِّيِّ, and those who follow the sunnah of our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So by having taqwa, by giving zakat, by believing in Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, by following the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is a reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. The rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Another reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is to have a rahmah to the other human beings and other creations of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ar-Rahimuna yarhamuhumullah, those who are kind, those who are merciful, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will have mercy on them. Irhamukum fil ardi, irhamukum fis samaa, have mercy, be kind to the people who are in the earth, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will have His mercy to you in His heavens. And sometimes, no matter how much ibadat and how much devout you are, if you are not a kind person, you will not get the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Remember the hadith that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was mentioning, a woman that fulana taqumu salat wa tasumu nahar walakinaha tu'ti jaha. They said that this lady taqumu al-layl, she prays qiyam al-layl all night long, وَتَصُومُ النَّهَارَ She fasts every day. But وَتُؤْذِي جَارَهَا She harms the neighbors. Look at Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم دَعُوهَا إِنَّهَا فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ Leave her because she will be among the people of Ahlul Nahr. Because she didn't have a mercy for the neighbors. Another reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, to not only to be kind to the humans, you know, Muslims and non-Muslims alike, but to also gain, to also have kind of other creations. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us a story of a woman, one of the prostitutes of Bani Israel, that one day she has seen a dog circling on a well, okay, very thirsty dog. And she said to herself, she has felt, you know, the thirst that this dog is going through, and she fetched water for this dog, and she gave it, and in return Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave that woman all her sins. Look, on the other side, there was a woman that has locked a cat in a house, and she did not feed that cat, neither did not let that cat feed herself and go around, and in return Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala punished that woman and put her in hell. And that woman was a good believer. Another reason to gain, if we need the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, is to reconciliate the brothers and those who are different, to bring them together, to always find a sulh. وَالسُّلْحُ خَيْرٌ Those who always walk on the sulh and bring people together, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will have mercy on them. He said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ That the mu'mineen are true brethren. فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ Reconcile between your brothers. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ And have taqwa لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ And indeed Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will have mercy on you. So by bringing people together, okay, by working out the relationship of those who have differences, that is a reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Also, another reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, without the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, will suffer severely, is to visit the sick brothers. If you have the time to do so, this is a wajib, this is what's called Haqqul Muslim ala al-Muslim. Well, al-Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ma min muslimin ya'ud musliman ay yazuru maridan aw ahallahu fi Allah ghadwatan awwal nahar illa salla alayhi 70,000 malakin haqqa yumsi. That nobody visits a sick brother and he stays with that 70,000 angels will seek forgiveness of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala for that person who is visiting the sick brother. So this is a means to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Another reason to remember to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is to listen to the Quran and to be quiet what the Quran is reciting. It is very important out of respect for the words of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَبِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ When the Quran is recited, listen. When the Quran is recited by a device or by an individual, listen to it. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to listen to that. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, and be quiet, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ And in return, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will have rahmah for you. So in order to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, we need to listen to the Quran, we need also to be quiet when the Quran is recited. Another reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is to return to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, to repent to Allah, to seek the forgiveness of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in return will have mercy on us. You know, to always go back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, because when we and we tend to commit mistakes and sins. But with the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah wants to go back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala when we repent to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive. No matter how much is that sin, some people think that when they go too far, they think that their sins will not be forgiven or they are too far now. But that's not how it is. Unlike the humans, if you go to a human being and ask, you know, for something, perhaps they will give you the first time, and then if you go back to them for the second time, they might give you for the second time, but if you go to any human being for the third time, it will be very difficult for that person to give you anything. They will keep coming back. What is this? But with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, it's different. Every time that you make a mistake, you go back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Every time that you commit a sin, you go back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. I never think that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will not forgive you. Allah said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Those who become hopeless because due to the mistakes and the sins, the gravity and the severity of the sins that they have committed, لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ, do not become hopeless from the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Because إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا, because Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala forgives all sins. In fact, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala loves and becomes content when His servants seek the forgiveness, His forgiveness. So much so that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in authentic hadith, there was a man in the desert, and this man fell asleep for a few, you know, minutes in a nowhere place, you know, around the desert. And as he woke up, the man could not find his camp, where he had everything on that camp. He had his food, he has his drink, he has all his provisions and sustenance. And the man looked everywhere, nothing but plain desert, nothing to see. So he became so hopeless, and he decided to wait, you know, the death to come to him. Because, you know, where would he go? Everywhere you see throughout the horizon, you know, it's a desert. No trees, no animals, nothing. So he decided to just wait the death to come to him. And he fell asleep. And then he woke up. And then when he woke up, all of a sudden he saw his camel on top of him, with his food, with his drink and everything. And he became so happy. You know, you can picture that, you can imagine that situation. And he said, Allahumma anta abdi wa ana rab. Oh Allah, you are my slave and I'm your Lord. Because of the farah, because of the happiness. Because Al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, so much so that that individual become happy, you know, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is happier than that man when you repent to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So repenting to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, you know, it makes Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, contents Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala more than what you think. Another reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is to have a sabr and patience, especially when calamities and when we face calamities and difficulties, as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, give good news and glad tidings for a sabirin. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala described who are as-sabirin, alladhina idha asabatuhum musiba, are those who calamities happen to them. Alladhina idha asabatuhum musiba, qalu inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, they say, we belong to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and return to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, ulaika alayhim salawatun min rabbihim wa rahmah, that those will be blessed by Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala and Allah will have mercy on them. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ, these are the ones that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala have guided. So every time that you face a challenge, every time that there is a death, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, every time that a death comes to you or a member of the family, every time that you get sick, or an individual that a friend or a relative or a parent gets sick, every time that you face this kind of difficulties and challenges, you should have patience, and Allah Ta'ala will have mercy on you, will have rahmah on you. Another reason to gain the rahmah of Allah Ta'ala is to pray Qiyamul Layl. To pray Qiyamul Layl, to wake up while everybody else is sleeping. Even if it's, you know, a rak'ah or rak'atayn, two rak'ahs, whatever you can, wake up in the middle of the night. When one third of the night is left, when you do that, Allah Ta'ala will have mercy. And Nabi especially with your wife, with your family, and Nabi Sallallahu said in this authentic hadith, he said, Rahim Allah rajulan, Allah will have mercy on a man, qama min al-layli, who stood up for salat, for salat and prayed, thumma aykada ahla, thumma aykada imra'ata. And he woke up his wife, for salat, and she prayed, فإن أبت, and if she refused to wake up, you know, because she feels so sleepy, not happy with her alma, he sprinkles, you know, a few drops of water on her, then she wakes up and they pray together. You know, they pray together. Nowadays people don't understand that. You know, a brother told him, if I do that, the next thing I expect is a slap on my face. SubhanAllah. But that's the sunnah of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to wake her up, and if she refuses to sprinkle some water on her, and you pray together as Jama'ah. And also, Rahim Allah, Imra, and Allah will have mercy on a wife, that does the same thing as Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. In another hadith, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Rahim Allah, Imra, and Salla, Qabla al-Asr, Arba'an, another sunnah to observe. If anybody who prays four rak'ahs before Salatul Asr, Allah Ta'ala will have mercy on that person, as in this hadith of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. If we need to gain the rahmah of Allah Ta'ala, what we need to keep in mind as well is that when we pray in Tidarul Salat, is Salat. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, La yazal al-abd fi salat, that the servant, the slave of Allah Ta'ala, will remain in a status of salat, prayers. Ma kana fi musalla, as long as he remains where he prayed. Yantadiru salat, waiting for the next salat. Waiting for the next salat. Wa taqulu al-malaika, and the malaika says, Allahumma aghfir lahu, Allahumma arhamhu, hatta yansarif, o yahmi. That as long as you're sitting there, two things happen. One, that period that you're sitting between the salah is considered to be a salah by itself. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told us in another hadith, you're actually gaining the ajr of a salah. Though you are sitting, you pray salat al-maghrib, you decide to remain in the masjid, okay? And wait for the other salah to be Quran or remain in the masjid seating. During that time, it is though as you are praying salah. One. Secondly, as long as you are there, the malaika makes dua for you. And they say, Allahumma aghfirlahu, oh Allah, forgive this person. Allahumma arhamhu, oh Allah, have mercy on this person until you leave that place. You see? And the dua, the supplication of the angels are accepted by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Another reason to gain the rahmah and the mercy of Allah Ta'ala is to be kind to your parents. That, in fact, causes a lot of abundance in the rahmah of Allah Ta'ala by fulfilling the command of Allah Ta'ala. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah commanded us to worship Him alone, and to be good to our parents, especially when they become old. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا. You know, there are times that Allah Ta'ala create the situation that you will have to take your parents, take care of them in old age. Okay, one of them or both of them. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍ. Do not say "uff," which means a word of hatred or a word of disrespect. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍ. tanharhuma, and this means don't push them and don't say something that they dislike. Wa qul lahumā qawlan karīmā, and say to them that which is right, that which is kind. Wa qul lahumā qawlan karīmā wa ighfir lahumā janāha dhulli min ar-raḥmah. Wa qul rabbi irḥamhumā kamā rabbayānī ṣaghīran, and make dua for them. So when the parents become older, in old age, they tend to lose their temper quickly and they become very angry very quickly. So we need to have patience and to be kind to our parents. And I wonder sometimes when I see many of us who are taking care of, our children, our wives, and we leave, aside our parents, subhanAllah. And I shall remind you, my respected brothers and sisters, Islam, that every time that we don't take care of our parents and we take care of our children, what you need to keep in mind, come to deal with that, that if you abandon your parents and you don't take care of them, most likely your children will do the same thing to you. So if you need to gain the rahmah of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, you need to be kind to your parents more than your wife and more than your children. This is very important. We understand that. Okay, many of us do neglect our parents. And sometimes I wonder when I see brothers who tell me, I haven't seen my mother or my father for so many years. They'll tell you, I haven't seen my father for 10 years, 20 years, and so on. And the next thing you hear is that my father passed away and died. SubhanAllah. What is more important for you to do, that is busy by not taking care of your parents, your father, your mother, and so on. So we have to have priorities in our life, my brothers and sisters, in Islam. Another reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is khashyatullahi fil ghayb, to remember Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala all the time, publicly and secretly, that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will have mercy on you. If you have, look, with the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, it's an amazing hadith that I'd like to share with you. This hadith, there was a man. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has given this man wealth, okay? Rasulullah malan. And when he has reached the death verge, okay, he called his children and he said, what kind of father I was? And they said, you were the best father. You were the best father you could be. And he said, فَإِنِّي لَمْ أَعْمَلْ خَيْرًا قَدْ. But unfortunately, they haven't done anything good, for his future. That's the future. That's where we are missing. He was good to his children, but not good to his role. And he said, فَإِذَا أَنَا مِتْ. When I die, فَأَحْرِقُونِي. Burn my body. And then throw me on the dust, in a wind day, throw me to the dust. Fi yawm al-'asr. And they have done that. Okay, they spread his ashes on the air. And then Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gathered. No matter how you die, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will resurrect us in any situation that we die, whether you're banned, whether you've been eaten by an animal, or whether you've been buried, you'll be brought the way you were. As Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, وَإِنَّ الْأَوَّلِينَ وَالْآخَرِينَ لَمَجْمُعُونَ إِلَى مِيقَاتِ يَوْمٍ مَعْلُومٍ رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ جَامِعُ النَّاسِ لِيَوْمٍ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said to this man, مَا حَمَلَكَ بِهَذَا, what made you do this? And he said, مَخَافَتُكَ, fear of you. Okay, I knew I was a bad man, and I was afraid of you and your punishment. And because of that feeling, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala had mercy on that man. Okay? Because of that feeling that this man had. Another reason to gain the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is to enjoy al-amru bil ma'ruf wa nahy anil munkar, is to enjoy that which is right, to stand for the haq, for the truth, to stop and forbid the evil, okay? To convey the message of Islam to the mankind. Allah Ta'ala said when he talked about a very long ayah, لَهُمْ سَيَدْخُلُهُمْ فِي رَحْمَتِهِ. Those who does what I have just said, Allah Ta'ala will put them into his rahmah. Allah Ta'ala said, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ أُولَئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ. إن الله عزيز حكيم. He said, المؤمنون, the believer man and the believer woman belong to each other because they're all believers of Allah تبارك وتعالى. And they join hands because يأمرون بالمعروف, they enjoy that which is right. وينهون عن المنكر, and they forbid and they stop that which is evil. You know, this is a requirement for every one of us. ويقيمون الصلاة, and they perform the salah. There is a difference between praying the salah and performing the salah. Okay? In the Quran, you will not find and any ayah that Allah Ta'ala says, do your salah. Says, perform salah. Performance of the salah has a deeper meaning than praying the salah. It consists of praying the salah on time, in the salat kanat ala al-mu'minina kitab al-mawquta, praying the salat jama'ah, praying the way that Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to pray, sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli, praying with khushu', walladhina hum fi salatihim khashi'un. All of this combined is called iqamatus salat. You know, praying the salat is just going and just praying the salat. That's different. But iqamatus salat means a combination of all these things. It's called, so wayuqimuna salat, وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ. And they also give zakat, and that's very important. Okay, and every time that you see salat, the next thing that you hear is zakat. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. And they obey Allah and His Messenger. أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ. Allah تبارك وتعالى will have mercy on these people. So, there are many ways that we can gain with the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and as I said, without the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, there is no life. No matter what you have, no matter how much is your position, no matter where you reach, we always need the rahmah of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. We ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala not to leave us a second without His mercy. Jazakumullahu khair wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد أيها الأحبة في الله، من طلب رحمة الله تبارك وتعالى وبذل أسبابها فسيجدها بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى وفضله ورحمته، فقد وجدها إبراهيم عليه السلام في النار، ووجدها يوسف عليه السلام في الجب وفي السجن، ووجدها يونس عليه السلام في بطن الحوت في ظلمات ثلاث، ووجدها موسى عليه السلام في موج اليم وفي قصر فرعون الطاغية، ووجدها أصحاب الكهف في ذلك الكهف الموحش، ووجدها المصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم هو وصاحبه صغار الطير، وهكذا أسباب جل رحمة رحمة الله تبارك وتعالى. من هذه الأسباب أيها الأحبة في الله الإيمان بالله تبارك وتعالى، وهو أول وأعظم الأسباب الجانبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى. فرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى لا يمكن أن تحصل إلا لمن آمن به تبارك وتعالى، الإيمان الحقيقي بجميع أركانه الستة، الإيمان بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله وباليوم الآخر وبالقدر خيره وشره قال جل وعلا: فأما الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فيدخلهم ربهم في رحمته ذلك هو الفوز المبين. ومن أسباب ومن أعظم الأسباب الجالبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى أيها الأحبة في الله طاعة الله تبارك وتعالى وطاعة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال جل وعلا: وأطيعوا الله والرسول لعلكم ترحمون. وقال أيضا: وأقيموا الصلاة وآتوا الزكاة وأطيعوا الرسول لعلكم ترحمون. ومن أعظم الأسباب الجانبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى اتباع الكتاب والسنة. قال تبارك وتعالى: وهذا كتاب أنزلناه مبارك فاتبعوه واتقوا لعلكم ترحمون. وقال أيضا: رحمتي وسعت كل شيء فسأكتبها للذين يتقون ويؤتون الزكاة والذين هم بآياتنا يؤمنون الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي. ومن أسباب ومن أعظم الأسباب الجانبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى أيها الأحبة في الله رحمة الخلق. فكيف يريد العبد رحمة الله وهو لا يرحم عباده؟ قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: الراحمون يرحمهم الرحمن، ارحموا من في الأرض يرحمكم من في السماء. وفي الحديث أنه قيل للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: فلانة تقوم الليل وتصوم النهار ولكنها تؤذي جيرانها. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: دعوها إنها من أهل النار. ومن ادعى أنه من أهل الإيمان وهو يؤذي عباد الله فهو على خطر عظيم أيها الأحبة في الله. وفي الحديث: من لا يرحم من لا يرحم لا يرحم. وقد أخبرنا أصحاب المسلم صلى الله عليه وسلم أن امرأة بقي رأت كلبا في يوم حار يطوف ببئر قد أضلع لسانه من العطش، فنزعت موقها وغفها فغفر لها، رواه إمام البخاري ومسلم. ومن أسباب أيها الأحبة في الله استجلاب رحمة الله تبارك وتعالى السعي في الصلح بين الإخوة المتخاصمين. قال الله تبارك وتعالى: إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم واتقوا الله لعلكم ترحمون. لأنه لا صلاح لإخوان المجتمع إلا بالأخوة والتسامح. ومن أعظم أسباب استجلاب رحمة الله تبارك وتعالى زيارة المريض. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: من عاد مريضا لم يزل يقول في الرحمة
هل هي رسالة الإسلام؟ رسالة الإسلام يا عباد الله. قال الله تبارك وتعالى لنبيه: وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. علينا أن نتراحم في الله. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من مسلم يخرج مسلما أن يزوره مريضا أو أخله في الله غدوة في أول النهار إلا صلى عليه 70,000 ملك حتى يمسي، وإن عاده عشية أي في المساء كذلك. أخرجه البخاري. ومن أعظم أسباب استجلاب رحمة الله تبارك وتعالى علينا التقوى. قال سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وآمنوا برسوله يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته. ومن أعظم الأسباب الجالبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى الاستماع والإنصات للقرآن الكريم، وكذلك مدارسته وتعلمه وتعليمه. فالقرآن الكريم كله بركة أيها الأحبة في الله، كله بركة ورحمة وفضل وهدى. وكلما أكثر العبد من قراءته وتعلمه كلما حصل المزيد من الفضل والبر والرحمة. قال الله جل وعلا: وإذا قرئ القرآن فاستمعوا له وأنصتوا لعلكم ترحمون. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: وما اجتمع قوم في بيت من بيوت الله تعالى يتلون كتاب الله ويتدارسونه بينهم إلا نزلت عليهم السكينة وغشيتهم الرحمة وحفتهم الملائكة وذكرهم الله فيمن عنده. ومن أعظم الأسباب الجالية لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى أيها الأحبة في الله الإفراغ من التوبة والاستغفار. فالإنسان محل الخطأ والنسيان، لكن الله تبارك وتعالى بلطفه ورحمته شرع التوبة والاستغفار. قال الله تبارك وتعالى: لولا تستغفرون الله لعلكم ترحمون. وقال شعيب عليه السلام في دعوته لقومه: واستغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه إن ربي رحيم ودود. كما أيها الأحبة في الله إن من أعظم الأسباب الجالبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى الصبر على المصائب. فالدنيا جملت على كدر وعلى تعب وهموم، ومن ثم فلن تستطيع حياة المسلم إلا بالصبر. قال تبارك وتعالى: وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولسائر المسلمين، فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وهو البر الكريم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. أيها الأحبة في الله، من أسباب الجلبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى علينا قيام الليل والتعاون على ذلك وإيقاظ الزوجين لبعضهم. فعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: رحم الله رجلا قام من الليل فصلى، ثم أيقظ امرأته فصلت، فإن أبت فضح في وجهها الماء. ورحم الله امرأته قامت من الليل فصلت، ثم أيقظ زوجها فصلى، فإن أبى فضح في وجهه الماء. والحديث في صحيح سنن أبي داود. ومن أعظم الأسباب الجالبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى أيها الأحبة في الله صلاة 4 ركعات قبل العصر. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: رحم الله امرأً صلى قبل العصر 4. ومن الأسباب أيها الأحبة في الله كذلك انتظار الصلاة. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: لا يزال العبد في صلاة، ما كان في مصلاه ينتظر الصلاة، وتقول الملائكة: اللهم اغفر له، اللهم ارحمه، حتى ينصرف
يحدث
ومن أعظم الأسباب الجالبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى أيها الأحبة في الله الإحسان. الإحسان مع الجميع أول، الإحسان مع الله تبارك وتعالى بمراقبته ومشيته وأحسن كما أحسن الله إليك، وثانيا الإحسان مع الوالدين وبالوالدين إحسانا، الإحسان في القول وقول للناس، الإحسان في القول كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى وقول للناس حسنا، وقال أيضا وقول لعبادي يقول التي هي أحسن، ومن ثم كان جزاء الإحسان الرحمة، قال تعالى ولا تفسدوا في الأرض بعد إصلاحها، ولا تفسدوا الأرض بعد إصلاحها. ومن أعظم الأسباب أيها الأحبة في الله الجالبة لرحمة الله تعالى تبارك وتعالى خشية الله في الليل والشهادة، فخوف الله ورجائه يورث عن العبد فضل الله ورحمته وغفرانه. قال تعالى ولما سكت عن موسى الغضب أخذ الألواح، وفي نسختها هدى ورحمة للذين هم لربهم يرهبون. وأخرج البخاري عن حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن رجلا كان قبلكم رزقه الله مالا فقال لبنيه لما خضر أي أخ كنت له؟ قالوا خير أب، قال فإني لم أعمل خيرا قط، فإذا مت فاحرقوني ثم اسلقوني ثم ذروني في يوم عاصف، ففعلوا. فجمع الله عز وجل فقال ما حملك؟ قال مخافتك يا رب، فتلقاه برحمته. رواه البخاري ومسلم. ومن أعظم الأسباب الجالبة لرحمة الله تبارك وتعالى أيها الأحبة في الله الإنفاق في سبيل الله. قال سبحانه وتعالى والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء بعض يأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر ويقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة ويطيعون الله ورسوله أولئك سيرحمهم الله إن الله عزيز حكيم. فاتقوا الله يا عباد الله واحرصوا على استجلاب رحمة الله بفعل ما تيسر من هذه الأسباب الكثيرة المتنوعة جعلني الله وإياكم من المرحومين. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا، ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا، ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به، واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا، أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.